Okay, myself Rajesh Shankar Rao Gowde, working as assistant professor at JSPM's Imperial College of Engineering, Pune. As in first part, calculation part is remaining. Now in part two, it will be part two of video, calculation part is there. That is calculation fuel saving from CHP. That is FS equal to in bracket FT plus FG bracket complete minus FCHP, where FS equal to total fuel savings. FT is equal to fuel use from displaced on-site thermal production, FG equal to fuel use from dispatch grid electricity, and FCHP equal to fuel use by the CHP system. Step 1, calculate FT and FG. Step 2, calculate FCHP through direct measurement. And step 3 is equal to calculate FS. Now, this is the part 2, calculating CO2 saving from CHP. C is equal to CT plus CG minus CCHP, where C is equal to total CO2 emission saving, CT equal to CO2 emissions from dispatch on-site thermal production, CG equal to CO2 emissions from displayed grid electricity, and CCHP CO2 emissions from the CHP system. In this way, step 1, step 2, 3, we have to calculate CS. This is the CHP emission calculator. For CHP emission calculator, CHP system characteristics. In this way, we have to calculate CO2 emissions. Now, this is the comparison of e-grid, fossil fuel and non-base load rates mapped onto hypothetical load curve. From this, when calculating the fuel and CO2 emissions saving associated with CHP, the partnership recommends using the e-grid emissions factors and heat rates for the e-grid sub-region where the CHP system is located. Although not as accurate as a detailed dispatch analysis, a comparison of the display generation from base load CHP to all fossil and non-base load areas suggests that the fossil fuel emission factors and heat rate are reasonable estimates for the calculation of dispatch emission and fuel for base load CHP system, that is greater than 6,500 annual operating hours. Similarly, for non-base load CHP system with relatively low annual capacity factors, that is less than 6,500 annual operating hours, and with a relatively high generation contribution during periods of high system demand, the most appropriate estimate of displaced generation is represented by the non-base load emission factor and heat rate. Thank you.